What's up, guys? Jimmy Urquhouse, welcome back to another Top 10. Today is going to be the Top 10 Best Launchers in Call of Duty history. Real quick, I want to remind you there is plenty of time for you guys to enter my Twitter giveaway. Somebody is going to win the sold-out PlayStation 4 version of the Black Ops 3 Juggernog Edition. So link in the description. You guys go enter. It's free to enter. Somebody's going to get really lucky. I've got two of them. I'm keeping one, and I'm giving one away. Now, let's jump right into this best launchers, and this includes airburst, it includes grenade launchers, rocket launchers, any type of projectile launcher in COD history. If you're new to the series, this is where you guys decide what goes up, and I put them in order according to how many tweets you guys gave me. Drop a like on the video if you guys would while you're watching, and let's go. Number 10, from King of Rushing, Advanced Warfare Stinger M7 had 4 missiles and was capable of killing multiple people too. Hashtag Chaos Top 10. And you're going to see a couple Advanced Warfare launchers on here. They definitely brought it when it came to launchers. A lot of people enjoyed the Advanced Warfare launchers, especially the Stinger M7. Like he said, having 4 missiles, this thing becomes very versatile. It's not a one shot and then you're just running around with it on your back and you can't use it again until you die. So definitely a good pick. Coming in at number 9 from Alex Hill, I'm Diabetes on Twitter. One of the best launchers in COD was the rifle grenade from World at War. Heavily satisfying when you killed someone. Hashtag Chaos Top 10. If you don't remember this or if you never used this, plugging this thing on the end of your rifle, this thing was amazing. I don't remember how many you got, but it seems like you got a bunch of them and you could go after tanks with this thing. You could get dudes that were camping in the back with this thing. Anything in World at War was just like they put a nuke in your hand when it came to a launcher. So very, very good pick. Coming in at number 8 from Wimmaloy10, the Modern Warfare 2 Grenade Launcher, aka the Noob Tube. It's so OP, millions of people hate it. It definitely is so infamous. When you think of Modern Warfare 2, you think Noob Tube, One Man Army, and the list goes on and on. It definitely solidified itself in history, but if you're talking about the best, it was really good. I mean, this thing was very, very powerful. It had a big explosive rate of, I guess you could say, proximity. Everything in Modern Warfare 2 blew up bigger than other Call of Duties, but we have to put it on the list. It's part of the history. Coming in at number 7, from That Crazy Gamer, has to be the Mayhem from Advanced Warfare. Great damage and really the only usable one in Advanced Warfare. I disagree with that. There's 2 or 3 of them that are pretty usable in Advanced Warfare, but this one is definitely really gnarly. This is a nasty launcher when it comes to the Mayhem, and you can get all kinds of different versions. They don't really do anything with the stats, but you can get some really cool versions of this in Advanced Warfare. Coming in at number 6 from Villainous Vibe, the Smaw from Black Ops 2, lock on and free fire with high explosive radius. Other launchers just can't compete. Hashtag Chaos Top 10. I think more people probably ran around with the Smaw. Maybe the RPG was up there too, but the Smaw was definitely the go-to launcher from what I remember. And like he said, you can lock on or you can free fire it just like the RPG. So it was usable. It was usable in multiple situations. So definitely, definitely a good pick. Now let's jump into the top 5. Me Bulldog 1713. The Panzer Schreck. It was literally a mini nuke launcher. Once again, anything in World at War seemed like it was on steroids when it came to explosive damage, and the Panzer Schreck was no different. You could literally feel the power of this thing when you launched it at something, and if it hit it, it was game over. Multi-kills, tanks go down, whatever it may be. It's got a really, really badass name as well. That's why it garnered the number 5 spot. Coming in at number 4, this was just dumb. We'll call you Fizzy. Call me Fizzy. The Modern Warfare 2 Javelin pre-patch. You could control an entire map with that thing. Not only that, but you could get a multi-kill off of spawn. This thing was annoying and very, very powerful. Everybody was running around with this huge javelin and just going for spawn kills with this. I remember Wasteland. It was like toxic when it came to javelins everywhere on spawn with this thing. So definitely deserved to be on the list because it was one of the best when it came to actually doing what it was supposed to. Coming in at number 3, from Mayus 2000, the War Machine from Black Ops 2, wrecked people all day long. Hashtag Chaos Top 10. The War Machine changed the dynamic of clearing out a room. That's when we got introduced into Hardpoint with Black Ops 2, and there was nothing better than getting a War Machine and going and breaking the hard point. You literally became a one-man wrecking crew with this thing. It was just the way it sounded, the way it exploded. It was just, you felt unstoppable when you were running around with this war machine. Definitely a good pick. Coming in at number two for Mr. Bam Baroni, best Twitter name so far, hashtag Chaos Top 10. This would have been number one if it was up to me. The Grim Reaper from Black Ops 1 was such a cool launcher, plus a cool name. Coolest name besides the Panzer Shrek to me in Call of Duty history. And you literally felt like you were Terminator with this big square thing mounted on your shoulder. The Grim Reaper was beyond nasty when it came to getting kills and just unleashing mayhem on people. And I would have put it at number one personally. That's just me. But number one, we have to show our respect. Tom Kirby SVSP says, hashtag Chaos Top 10. The RPG from any game needs to at least be an honorable mention. It's just the classic launcher feel. Now, I wouldn't call it the best, but so many people tweeted at me, I had to put it at number one because it is. When you think of launchers in Call of Duty, the first thing that comes to mind is the RPG. Now, it may not be the most accurate, but it's one of those let it fly and hope they die. And I did just make that up. I didn't grab that anywhere, so it's pretty good on the fly. But yeah, the RPG definitely is in the hearts of everybody. So it got the number one spot. A couple honorable mentions for you really quick. C4 Tune Teller says the XM25 from Modern Warfare 3. You could choose the range at which it explodes, useful to get campers out of their nest. You could literally like adjust this thing to, he's right. You could get people that were hiding behind stuff with it. You could airburst behind them. This was a really cool airburst launcher to use. Then from Eggthin324, the Stinger from Modern Warfare 2 with killstreaks, that OP, it's good to have a lock-on launcher, and the Stinger was great at that. And last but not least, from OpticNadeShot09, Thumper from Modern Warfare 2, best noob tube out there. I didn't really care for the Thumper or the China Lake, but some people definitely liked them. So there you go, guys. The best launchers in COD history picked by you guys. Be sure to enter that PS4 Juggernaut Edition giveaway. They are sold out completely, so you may have a chance to win this. Somebody's going to win it. Hope you guys have a great day.